Good morning. Welcome to TERRA at Home. We are in Hanleys in Ancaster, and I'm here with Carol, and we're in the upstairs in the clothing area, and oh so beautiful. We are getting ourselves ready for New Year's Eve and beyond, which is the whole point of all of this, right, Carol?
Right, and welcome.
Thank you
very much.
Happy
holidays.
Thank you, you too.
Or should I say hip holidays?
Yes, that's what we're looking at, right? Yeah. We're, again, when the first thing you said to me was, gone are the, you know, we're not talking about the fairy princess going out for New Year's right now. We're talking about versatility and being able to take that outfit that you wear on New Year's, to, regardless of whatever event or party you're going to, and use it again.
Exactly. We're not going to the prom. We're going to the club. We're going to the chalet. Mm-hmm. We're going to a fabulous restaurant for dinner. Mm-hmm. And these are investment pieces.
Yes.
And we want to make sure that the girls can put them in their closet and wear them time and time again.
Now, before we get to that, the trend right now that we're talking about, we're seeing lots of black and we're seeing leather.
Yeah, black is back.
Mm-hmm. Which is fun, because
yeah,
I love it.
As if it ever left, right?
Right, exactly.
Because there were three people, I think, who bought orange. But black is definitely back, mm-hmm. and with a vengeance. Mm-hmm. And it is, leather is everywhere. Mm-hmm. Everything you can think of.
Even
dresses.
In like the sweatshirt style, they're putting in little inserts of leather, right?
Yeah, so. And that's what we refer to kind of in the business as mixed media.
Right.
So you're finding a lot of things with leather sleeves and leather fronts and leather backs, mm-hmm. and leather sequins. Yeah, mm-hmm. it's really quite spectacular.
Okay, well we're going to show an outfit. We're going to go through three different outfits, three different looks for New Year's, and our first one is going to the club.
Yes.
Right.
Caitlin's going to the club. She's wearing a spectacular Alexander Wang leather shorts. Yeah, she has on her little L.K. Bennett booties, which are very sexy.
I like those a lot.
Yeah, she's wearing, and we have to get you from the limo to the club. Mm-hmm. So she's got her fur-lined Helmut Lang jacket. Also mixed media, you can see the leather trim on this jacket. And mm-hmm. it's that new proportion, which is, we're showing a lot of volume.
Yes.
In our coats this season, and you can see that. It's completely lined in fur.
Mm. So that'll keep you toasty warm, especially with what you're about to see that's underneath it, because there's not much.
Very bad bunny inside that coat. Yeah.
So there you go. Bam!
Yeah, Caitlin has her beautiful t-shirt that is chiffon, and it has leather sequins.
Yes, and that's the thing. If you could just at home reach out and touch right now, I went up and had to look up close, but they're little square, tiny little leather sequins that are dotted on the entire top.
Yeah, exactly.
Wow, so we have her just sporting a cute little lacy bra under there, but you could wear a tank, you could do whatever you need to do.
Do you know what, let's be honest, most women would put a little tank.
Yeah, mm-hmm. well, because they're going to get a lot of attention at night if they don't.
Exactly.
But it's very cute, I love it, great mm-hmm. look. Very nice. So again, what is kind of neat about this whole thing is you're saying the leather shorts are here, and because the leather is back, we're getting back into leather pants too. So that's kind of fun.
Oh, yeah,
the whole thing,
course,
right?
Of course. And those shorts, Leslie, can be put on with a pair of tights, mm-hmm. a flat over-the-knee boot, mm-hmm. a big chunky sweater, and suddenly your New Year's Day outfit is, you know, ready to go.
Sure.
Yeah,
I love that. So that's the versatility of it all, right?
Yeah, and you can wear them all year. Mm-hmm. You can wear them in the summer with a white t-shirt and a pair of sandals.
Right, mm-hmm. very good. Okay, so now we'll pull in our next model. So going to a longer, these are actually leather leggings.
Yeah, so this is the hottest leather legging in the marketplace. This is Helmut Lang, and again, I wish the ladies at home could see these, because they actually have a little bit of a sparkle in them.
Yes.
They're amazing. They almost have a suede finish.
I was going to say, I had to touch them, because they do. They have, they're sort of like that brushed kind
they
of
are.
Feeling to
they
them.
They are, and they're a little bit iridescent, which kind of, you know, ties back into her necklace, which again, the big chunky necklaces are so important this season. It's nice to have a little bit of sparkle.
Well, that's the thing, right? Because then you can see as you pull that necklace off, that sweater just becomes very casual.
Right. And personally, I love cashmere back to leather. I like to soften it up a little mm-hmm. bit. Mm-hmm. I think that it's very important. And you can just imagine, you know, showing up at the boyfriend's house in your sexy sweater and your leather pants.
Yeah.
What could
I bet
be
you
better?
You can imagine too.
What could be better? And the little booties that she has on.
Mm-hmm.
Again, we can imagine those on a different day with a skinny pair of jeans mm-hmm. and a fabulous blazer.
Right.
Big scarf, some fingerless mittens, and she can go to work.
And that's the great part. So again, we're looking at the fact that here we are, okay, now we can wear this to New Year's, she can wear this to a lovely house party or out for dinner, but again, she can wear this another time. It's not about that's going in the closet tonight and she's not going to wear it again until next holidays or a Christmas party.
Absolutely, absolutely. I've had clients buy these twice. Uh-huh. Buy them. they've worn them out. They've worn them to death. You wouldn't think you could wear them out.
Yes.
They've worn them to death.
Helmut's
been showing these for a couple of seasons.
Thank you.
They've loved them so much, they've bought them again.
Yeah, so that's the great part about it all. And leggings are just so in right now, too, of any nature. So to have leather ones, it spruces it up just a little bit more.
I think they've really become basic.
Yeah, they really have. Okay, now we're looking at this amazing dress. So now we're just going to spice it up a little bit more if you are going to quite a more of an upscale do, but you can still wear leather.
Yeah, so now we're going to a party. You know, we're going to a fabulous party in a restaurant, or we're going out in the evening. I mean, there was a dress not unlike this that showed up on the red carpet. And one of the celebrities was wearing one quite similar. And it's leather, laser cutout.
Wow.
With a nude underslip. And Kristen's wearing it with a pair of fabulous little booties to give it a bit of an edge.
That's the difference too, right? So you could take that and wear it with a different heel if you want. But the booty thing is just...
I think I've lied. I think I said Kristen had it on with booties, but I think she's actually put it on with a pair of pumps. Wouldn't matter. She could wear it with either or, but Kristen...
Yeah. That's the thing, though, right? You can wear it with either, and that's
the
great part about it all.
Sorry, because her sister, Caitlin, has worn this dress out with little booties.
Okay.
This time, because we wanted to make it just that much dressier, we did put it on with the high heels.
But again, it gives you a different look, a bit of an edge when you wear it with the booties, I find, right?
Absolutely.
Where when you take it and you wear it with the heels, that's where you can kind of sort of dress it up a little bit more, streamline it, maybe fit in with some of the people that are wearing the sparkly fairy dresses.
Yeah, absolutely.
The prom dresses, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah. So again, it gives you different looks. So again, you can wear that dress again. It's because it's a beautiful outfit that you can throw a little jacket on with or something like that and wear it again.
Absolutely. Caitlin, actually, Kristen's sister, actually wore that dress to a wedding in the summer.
Really?
We did it with a nude platform shoe, and it was amazing.
That's cool. That's really, really neat. So again, it's all about talking about leather and black, and so the trends for New Year's, really, it's make that your focus, because it doesn't matter where you're going, you can still get away with any of these outfits and just make it your own by depending on, again, accessorizing, which you guys have a lot of, and shoes and jackets, right?
Yes,
and
absolutely.
Changing things up a little
and
bit.
Again, you know, when we're talking about putting things together that maybe are not quite so predictable.
Yes.
You know, and that's fashionable in every aspect of our life.
Yeah, but branch out a little bit, because some people are afraid to wear a booty with a dress if they've never done it before. And they're not sure if it looks good, but it actually does look good.
Right, and there are some rules. The little booty should come quite close over your ankle.
Yes.
You know, if you're going to wear it with your dress. If you're going to put a big chunky sweater over some of these things, which is very fashionable at the moment, you want to make sure your chunky sweater is grazing the hemline of your dress.
Okay.
You know, there's a big cashmere sweater over that dress would be spectacular.
Yeah.
And in terms of accessories, we even have incredible leather accessories. So let's say you want to be...
Your gloves.
Very special. We have this long leather glove that you can wear out with your little dress on New Year's Eve.
More unfortunately
give
at
you
the time,
a little coverage.
But thank you. So that's really good, actually. So again, beautiful, great stuff at Hanley's here in Ancaster, getting yourself ready for New Year's in just a few days. Happy New Year's.
Happy
we'll be back
New
with
Year.
More Terra at Home. Thank you.
Where color lives. The Hamilton Spectator, at work, at home, or on the go. Read us online, in print, or download us to your e-reader. Get the Hamilton Spectator, any way you want it.
Welcome back to Terra at Home. I'm back here with Gillian Love as we edge closer to the end of the year
of 2013.
New Year. Yes, thank you, you too. Okay, so one of the things, of course, we like to talk about this time of year, lots of celebrating going on, and so variations of bubbles, sparkling wines.
Mm-hmm. And there is, Leslie, there's bubbles. You can buy a sparkling wine for $7 a bottle, or you can buy it for $400 or $500 a bottle. It goes way, but it's so much fun. The big thing this holiday season and going into New Year is rosés. Huge.
Yes, I love them. So does my mom.
And you know, we have the perception, or some of the consumers have the perception, that they are sweet, and they're not.
I know, because they've had maybe that one kind of one that wasn't very good, and it was very sweet and made them not feel very good.
Right.
But there are some fantastic ones that are drier.
When you get a lot of residual sweetness, then you get, you know, you get that syrupy, sickly, it's not clean. And the whole idea behind a sparkling wine or champagne is to cleanse the palate. Mm-hmm. It's not something, although we are going into New Year and everyone likes a bubbly, but it really is an everyday beverage, believe it or not, because it does go with a multitude of different foods. It's great with potato chips, honestly.
Is that how you roll, Gillian?
Yeah. But we have a huge spectrum of sparkling wine. So the Dom Perignon is the big cream
the
of
big
the
guns
crop.
Over here.
And it's come out with a sparkling rosé this holiday season. $300. It is pricey, but it's a vintage champagne. So the difference between vintage champagne and a regular champagne, first of all, champagne is a region in France. Mm-hmm. The vintage champagne is made in exceptional years using exceptional grapes, usually from a select vineyard, one specific vineyard, whereas champagne is blended for consistency year after year. So the grapes are sourced from all over Champagne in France, and there's main areas in France where they source their grapes from.
Okay.
So the Bollinger is a great one to come up if you want a nice classy champagne, lots of nice biscuit aromas and flavors. The bubbles are small, they last and linger in the glass, and they just they're just lovely and such a nice mousse in your mouth. Bollinger is a very, very trendy, popular, all the movie stars, all that, you see it in the Academy Awards. It's like a really
Looking at in terms of a price point on something like this?
That's an $89.
Yeah, so that's doable for some people. If you're taking it up a bit of a notch for you know, for New Year's, as you say, like that's something that maybe people can get their head around for a special day. Maybe not your everyday.
Right.
Right. Okay.
Then we get, as I said, the trends of the sparkling rosés. Now they come in all different price points. You can get them from France. You can get them from just outside the Champagne region. So you Cremant d'Alsace, Cremant de Loire, Cremant meaning cream. So they're creamy, lovely sparkling wines from just outside of Champagne. So they can't be called Champagne. But you know, $20 price
close
point.
Close
enough. So as opposed to $90 and $20, it's a good price
point. Okay. So say the average consumer was walking up to purchase a rosé and they don't want to get that sickly, sweet, sugary, but they don't want to spend a ton of money. Can you get one?
You can.
Without dropping a whole lot of money.
You're best to head to Cava's. Spanish Cava's are probably the best bang for your buck. You can get a $10 sparkling rosé from Spain that's dry, and you have aromas and flavors of cranberry and cherry, but it's not sweet, so you get that
nice
acidity to it. Great with foods, great with salmons and appetizers, holiday, you know, New Year's foods, things like that.
Okay.
This is a great little rosé.
I just like his toque.
Yes, the toque is so cute. So it's a great hostess gift too, if you're
really
going
is.
Over for a New Year's party to bring something like this. Again,
it is.
Yellowtail Bubbles, sparkling rosé. The little drink we made at the front.
Oh yes, let's talk about this.
Yeah, it's super easy to make, and I threw it into our sparkling segment here just because it's a great palate cleanser. Again, this is an iced elderflower liqueur, which is. We took a half a cup of elderflower liqueur, which is a French organic liqueur.
You've introduced that one to me, and it's beautiful.
It's really, really nice. You can use it in so many different things. So we used a half a cup of the elderflower liqueur and a half a cup of water with a little bit of lemon juice, and you throw it in the freezer in a flat pan, and you let it freeze for overnight, and then you kind of keep going, you know, whisking your fork through it to kind of, it looks like a snowball.
It's so
fun. And you can have it as a dessert or in between meals as a palate cleanser. So
so
you can also
good.
Add sparkling wine to it.
I was just thinking
make
that.
It into a cocktail. So How
oh,
neat.
That's so neat. Okay, so you said half a cup of?
Half a cup of the elderflower liqueur.
Yes.
Half a cup of water.
Half
that's
a cup
it.
Of water, and that's it. And
then
just pour it in the pan.
You can pour and lemon juice, a little
in
bit
lemon
of lemon juice,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then it
neat.
Ends up, yes, very neat, very interesting.
Always those just fun little things,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, just something a little different, and your guests will go, wow, isn't this something?
Yeah, you're so good and fancy.
So, also, other hostess gifts, if you're not a big party animal and you just want a little toast at New Year, then we have little piccolos, the little small.
That's always really nice to have, right?
Just enough for one or two glasses,
yes.
Just for a little, you know, Happy New Year cheer.
Sure.
So, we have great thematic bottles and beautiful glittery colors, so make sure you come in and visit. I wanted to mention too, social responsibility, always with the LCBO, we're very, very big on social responsibility. It's very important that your guests that are driving are not drinking. There's lots of different alternatives on our website under deflatetheelephant.com or lcbo.com, which gives you mocktails, cocktail ideas that you're just removing the alcohol. If you want something fizzy and bubbly like a sparkling wine, you can do ginger ales, you can do club sodas, Perrier mineral water, but you can add, you know, cranberry juice to it, things like that that just give it more.
Well, make
of
it fun for the people that are choosing not to drink, and for whatever reason they're choosing not to consume alcohol that night. You want to make it look like, you know, they have their own special drink for them as well, and something that's tasty, not like, hey, there's the water cooler over there, right?
Yeah,
and a lot of times people forget about them.
Yeah, and you and serve it
or
in
Coke.
A nice glass, like the glassware and everything is very important too, and the presentation is always.
Well, especially
everything.
If you're setting up like a little cocktail area and you're allowing people to make their own drink. Well, if you have, I find one, it's always nice to have variations in juices and that, so that people can kind of mix their own and without having to have the alcohol.
And that's another idea too, Leslie. You can absolutely make a little punch with a sparkling wine, just an inexpensive one, maybe a German, you know, Henkel or something like that.
Sure.
That's got a little bit of residual sweetness, so you're adding it with fruit punch or you're adding it with grapefruit juice or pineapple juice.
Yes, and that's just the thing, because sometimes people also like just to have a spritzer. So even if they are, you know, maybe not buying the best bottle of wine out there, but having some, if you were just having a white, for example, you don't have to go super high with that. If someone just wants to cut and have just a cocktail they can slip on for
just
a long period of time.
Exactly.
Right.
That's perfect for that.
Yeah. Definitely. Okay, so this gives us some good ideas for New Year's Eve, of course, the sparkling, but again, obviously lots of cocktail ideas and lots of partying to go on and fun times, but again, it's all about being responsible.
Very much, and when you're hosting a party, always make sure that you have a taxi for your guests or, you know, an overnight accommodations for them, and that they're not drinking. It's very important. We do offer tips on our website too, as to because it can get very uncomfortable trying to deal with somebody who's,
because a lot of times people think they're okay.
And it just shows you what you can do to make it easier for your guests.
Well, thank you. You know your stuff. We always appreciate it. We thank again to Millcroft LCBO and you, Gillian.
Thank you, Leslie. Happy New Year to you.
All right, that's it for now. We'll be back with more Terra at Home.
Where color lives.
You've sat under them and built forts in them. You've swung from them and fell out of them. You've even fallen in love under them. Trees have always held a special place in our hearts and memories. A natural beauty, trees will grow with you and your family and bring color and nature into your world. For your assurance of quality, look for trees and shrubs with the Medallion Plant tag. Medallion Plants, locally grown, the pride of Niagara.
Good morning, welcome to Terra at Home. We're here with Chef Iain today, and we are using the Go Cooking School classroom right now at the Hamilton Spectator, so thanks again to those guys for letting us use their kitchen.
Great to be here.
And we are making something because we are days away from New Year's Eve now.
Yes, absolutely.
So a lot of times people have just gatherings at their houses, which is actually very comfortable to do, and you have kind of a good idea for an appy.
Just a last minute appetizer, you know, companies all of a sudden coming in a few hours, you know, what we can put together with a glass of wine.
Glass of wine would be key.
Always key. essentially what I have is a lovely puff pastry, with some caramelized onions. I've got some wild and tame mushrooms, and we're going to use some gorgonzola and some brie cheese. Mm. Sounds pretty good.
It's a good combination of ingredients that should all come together nicely.
Yeah,
all
a little fresh tarragon on top. Well, what we're going to do is we're going to talk about caramelizing the onions first and foremost.
Okay.
Your first instinct is, you know, you cut your cut your onions and you throw them into the fry pan, mm-hmm. and you know, you keep it on the heat and you keep it turning.
Yes.
You really need to dial it back. You got to start to slow it down a little bit.
Just chill out.
They really need to be just left alone. Exactly. Okay. It's on a slow and low heat. Mm-hmm. And again, you just let the onions sit by themselves and release their own sugars.
Okay.
And after a while, they start to break down and they start to sweat. And
now, is there an oil? Is it oil? Did you use olive oil?
Great question. I use a little splash of olive oil,
okay.
just to start to keep the pan nice and...
But not too much, right?
Not too much. Okay. You don't need it. And ultimately, added our onions in and left it alone. Towards the end, when they're starting to dry out just a little bit, what I do is I add a little balsamic vinegar, just to add that little bit of flavor,
yes.
a little bit of sweetness, and again, sort of bring some of that color. And like I said, if you just leave them to themselves, and you get this wonderful, great product afterwards.
Okay.
And it really, really shows.
And that's good to have because, I mean, they're good for so many different types of recipes, even if you're just making sausage on a bun some night for everybody and
most
having
definitely.
A fun Oktoberfest or something.
Key French onion soup.
Yeah,
and again,
exactly.
Just keep it slow and low.
Mm-hmm.
Puff pastry, you can get in any local supermarket. You buy them by the roll. Just stretch it out. I use a little bit of parchment paper lined. It's just easier when it comes to transferring off your
cookie
sheet.
Yeah, I just noticed you did that. Okay.
And one of my biggest tricks when it comes to working with puff pastry, if I'm going to put any sort of wet ingredients onto it, the first thing I learned is you take a fork and you just make little holes throughout the puff pastry. It just allows it to breathe and let the air get underneath,
mm-hmm.
and ultimately it'll just be nice and crispy little crust.
So versus it being, I guess if you don't have any holes under here, that part just sort of sticks and stays soft.
It stays soft, and
okay.
the heat gets trapped underneath, and when you come to cutting it, you know, you don't have that crispy
yes,
crunch,
so that's why that
and you
happens.
Come to pick it up and
oh,
it slides
that's
off.
That's a good tip.
It's just a really nice sort of, it
okay.
plays it out well.
Mm-hmm.
Most of, you know, this segment is going to be just assembly of putting this together,
mm-hmm.
so first and foremost, I have some caramelized onions that I've already done before. Like I said, slow and low heat. When they start to dry out just mm-hmm. a little bit, I add just a little bit of balsamic vinegar.
Now, do you let those cool before you put them?
Another really
here?
Great question. That's right. You really should let
okay.
them cool from stage one to stage two.
Okay.
Just allow it for a little time to cool down
okay.
instead of putting it right onto the hot onions onto the surface.
Sure.
And like I said, we're just going to spread things out pretty liberally. And no, some great flavors with, again, you've got the fresh tarragon, you've got some of the gorgonzola cheese,
mm-hmm.
which is a little bit of a bite. Not everybody loves blue cheese, but it really does meld well with the flavors. You've got the earthy mushrooms.
Yes,
and you've
I
got
mean, those
the sweet
things
onions.
Just, they all kind of, you see those common threads, they all sort of just work right together. Then, of course, you're having brie as well, as you
brie
mentioned, right?
Is,
so that's so mellow and smooth and soft, so that'll kind of help.
Yeah. Most definitely. This is a great idea. Like I said, it doesn't take an awfully long time. From start to finish with your onions, maybe 20 minutes.
Okay.
So again, while the onions are sort of melding away on their own.
Well, you could do that in advance too, right? You could do that the day before.
You can do that the day before.
Yeah, okay.
And again, just it's assembly,
mm-hmm.
you know? And this is kind of an appetizer where you can pay attention to your guests. You know, you
yes.
throw a few things
which is
together.
It's hard to do sometimes when you're in the kitchen to try to do
year.
Both, right?
Exactly, exactly.
For the average Joe, anyway, not the chefs, but you guys are just used to doing that stuff.
Fair
Whereas
enough.
We're like panicking. Oh, I'm burning yep. things while I'm trying to talk to you.
I also like to bring the sort of the ingredients right to the edge.
Okay.
You know, every little bite that you should have a little taste of everything on it.
That's great.
So it's good.
Okay.
So from there, let's talk about the wonderful world of mushrooms.
Yes.
I've got some different mushrooms here.
I like how you called them wild and tame.
Wild and tame. I've got some cremini. Cremini is the start of a portobello mushroom.
Mm-hmm.
It's a young portobello mushroom. It hasn't come to full bloom yet. So that's my tame
really?
Mushroom. Yep.
Oh.
We've got some king mushrooms is what I'm about to put down now. They're wonderful in meaty flavor. And they have a lot of bite to them.
Mm.
And that's what's called a king mushroom.
Okay.
One of my favorites. And they look really, really great on the plate.
Mm-hmm.
And the next one we have is shiitake. Shiitake is, me too, very earthy, earthy flavor.
Earthy, yeah.
Yeah. So from there, I've also got some wonderful delicate oyster mushrooms. It's gray oyster mushrooms, and they look a lot like,
There's one right there.
Yep. When it comes to cooking mushrooms...
It looks like an oyster, right, when you pulled it out, doesn't it?
It does, doesn't it?
Where does it get its name from?
With mushrooms, again, you cook with a little bit of splash of olive oil. You start to brown your mushrooms. Towards the end is when I add a little pat of butter, because everything tastes better with butter.
Mushrooms particularly need butter. I find they just make them so...
So a little bit of butter, a little bit of thyme, and the season of thyme, sorry. Mm-hmm. And yeah, just finish them off.
Okay.
Each mushroom takes a little bit of different timing. You know, with your cremini and your king mushrooms, they're heartier, they take a little longer. Mm-hmm. So we would put my oyster mushrooms in at the very end just to finish them off.
Okay. So, all right, and then lastly, before we go to break, we put on the cheese.
We put on the all-important cheese.
Yes.
And I understand that we're going to go to break while I'm still putting cheese ingredients
on. We're good.
But
so how long are you going to put this in the oven for?
10 to 12 minutes.
Okay.
And until, you know, or until the corners start to turn up and start to get a little brown.
What's great about it is it's just so quick to put together. Again, if you have all these ingredients set and ready to go, that, as you say, is good for entertaining because you can just whip this up and do it.
Put it into the oven. Absolutely.
Good to go. And again, you know, as you say, not everybody loves gorgonzola because it has a little bit of a stronger flavor to it, but you can...
You can try different cheeses, absolutely.
But the combination
goat cheese,
is good.
Mm-hmm. Always a good flavor as well.
Okay, so let's do this. We'll take a quick break. We're going to put this in the oven. We'll come back and show you the final product.
Wonderful.
Where color lives.
Welcome back to Terra at Home. I'm here with Chef Iain, and we officially have some good smells in our kitchen right now.
Yes.
This has been in the oven roughly how long?
8 to 12 minutes.
Okay.
I just wanted to make sure that I got the crust nice and golden brown.
Mm-hmm.
It's a puff pastry crust. What we had started with some caramelized onions, talked about the slow and low heat. We've added a few different wild and tame mushrooms. We talked about our gorgonzola cheese, some brie cheese, some fresh tarragon. Ultimately, it's a great appetizer snack idea. Mm-hmm. You've got company coming over within the hour. It's something that you can readily put together quite
quickly.
And lots
quickly. Of options, too, when you have a puff pastry like this. I like the idea of putting on the parchment paper. And again, really, just once you do something like this, you could make a few different versions of these with different
toppings,
right?
Almost definitely could. Absolutely. And you can make them ahead of time, even if you liked.
Mm-hmm.
And that's certainly an option anyways.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
Okay, as always, while you're putting that up, I just wanted to mention, of course, you can find our recipes on our website at terragreenhouses.com. Again, you can collect them all, and that way you've got all your... in your back pocket, if you know if someone's coming over, some great ideas. Oh, this looks amazing.
It's good.
And it really is. This is what people actually really enjoy is, again, just coming over. A lot of times people don't even like that formal meal anymore.
Yep.
It's about taking a big island center spread and just putting out all different types of appetizers, especially this time of year when, you know, you don't really want to have a big sit-down meal. It's just everybody's walking around.
No, I like that. Absolutely. You've got a great opportunity, a glass of wine.
Mm-hmm.
And again, this is a kind of an opportunity where you can be with your guests. You know,
yes.
You're not in the, you know, locked away in the kitchen, mm-hmm. looking after many different mm-hmm. courses and things like that.
Right. Or we can just have you come over and
or
do it
all. Or have me come over and I'll be happy
once
to.
Once in a while, maybe we'll throw you a glass of wine.
You're very
How
kind.
About that?
You're very good to me.
Happy New Year.
Thank you. Happy New Year to you too.
Happy New Year to all you guys. Thanks for watching our show. And we have a whole other year of fantastic things to come on Terra at Home. So thanks for hanging out with us. Yay! Ding, ding, ding. Happy New Year. See ya.